Hi, welcome back to Academle. And in this tutorial, I'll be making a basic SolidWorks exercise. And actually, I'm creating a new playlist of SolidWorks basic exercise. And mostly, I'll cover SolidWorks tutorials. I'll also cover some AutoCAD and Creo tutorials. And today I'll make this basic exercise in which I'll cover some basic commands, for example a basic 2D sketch and basic extrusion, some chamfers, and we have a rib command here, and also extrude cut, and how to give dimensions, etc. So let's start. And first of all, you have to choose any of these planes. I'll choose top plane. Go to top plane and select sketch, and we'll make a rectangle, center rectangle, and the dimension of this rectangle is 65 by let's say 30, because the dia of this this block is 30, but I'll not make 65, I'll make 80 by 30, because the dia of this half circle or semicircle is 30, and the radius of this circle is 50 mm, if I can see from here. So 15 plus 65 will make 80. So I'll make a rectangle of 80 by 30, right? And I'll give it as 80. And the other dimension will be 30, because the dia of this semicircle is 30 mm, right? And we'll exit the sketch. Next, I'll extrude this portion to 9 mm, as you can see from here. And I'll go to features, I'll go to extrude boss command, and I'll select this sketch, this 2D sketch, and I'll change it to 9 mm, and I'll press OK. So this is the basic extrusion command, and we are done with this base. Next, we'll make let's say a sketch on this top side, and the sketch will be a semicircle and a circle, right? So I'll go to this face, I select this face, I'll go to sketch and select sketch, and I'll make it normal, right? Next, I'll choose three-point arc, and this three-point arc will be tangent to this line, tangent to this line, and tangent to this line as well, right? The arc has turned to black, which means that it is fully defined. And I'll make another circle, this time full circle of 7.5 radius, which means 15 dia. And I'll go to circle, and I'll make a circle of let's say, it is showing diameter, so I'll make 15. In the drawing, we have given 7.5 radius, not diameter, so I'll make 15 dia, right? The sketch is done. Next is this 18 mm dimension, and this dimension is given from the center of this circle to this line. So I'll choose point, I'll make a point on let's say here. I'll go to smart dimension and I'll give a dimension of let's say 18 mm, right? And now I'll go to line and I'll make two lines. I'll make two lines, right? And another line, right? So we are almost done with this 2D sketch, and now I have to extrude, or I have to press pull this 2D sketch, right? As you can see from this picture, we have already extruded 9 mm when we were making the base, and it is showing that the top side is 30 mm. The total height of this block is 30 mm, but we have already done or we have already extruded 9 mm, so I have to make an extrusion of 21 mm, that is 30 minus 9. So go to features, go to extrude boss command, and I'll make 21 mm extrusion, right? So we are done with this command, and in the end I'll make some extrude cut from this side and from this side, because I need a throughout hole, and then I'll make a rib here. And the basic purpose of rib is to make is to give reinforcement for your structure, and you can make it from a 2D sketch, but I think it is better to make from the features. So the thickness of this rib is 7 mm, so I'll go to right plane. In fact, I'll go to front plane, go to sketch and make it normal, and in fact I'll go to just exit it. I'll go to features, I'll go to rib, and it is asking the plane, so I'll select front plane, and now I'll go to line command, and just I need these two points, press escape, just rotate it, go to exit, and I need 7 mm rib, so and 7 mm rib on both sides, right? So press OK, and now we are done with this rib command, right? Next, I need two chamfers, 9x9, and I can also make these chamfers from 2D command, but as I have already mentioned that it is better to make these commands from the features, as we have done this rib command. So go to chamfer, and I need a chamfer of let's say 9 mm of equal distance. There are five type of chamfers in SolidWorks, so I'll make it 9, and I'll make two chamfers of 9 mm, right? So we are done with this chamfer command as well, and next I have to cut this unwanted portion. So I'll go to top plane, go to sketch, and I'll make just select this line, this line, this line, this line, and this arc, and also this circle, and go to convert entities, and it will make your 2D sketch automatically, right? And now go to exit, go to features command, and go to extruded cut command. And because there are two contours, in fact three contours, so go to contours, select this one and this one, and I need through all cutout. Press OK, and now we are done with this cutout as well. As you can see, this is a throughout hole. Last but not least, I'll apply some colors, or you can apply some appearance from here and from here. Here you can change your background, but I think it is better to use plain white. I'll apply some color as I have applied here, and go to colors, and you can apply colors from here as well, from here as well, and in fact you can have your colors from here as well. 181 by 255, and last one is 55. I have already written these values, so the color is same, and we are done with this SolidWorks basic exercise. Here you have your display styles, shaded with edges, shaded, and hidden lines, and basically there are five types of these display styles, and I think it is better to use shaded with edges, and we can use its cross section from three axes, and we can also rotate these in any of these axes, but I think it is not necessary here. I'm just showing you that you can use these options, and these options are very helpful when you are making an assembly or making a complex part. So that's it from today's tutorial of SolidWorks basic exercise. I hope you have enjoyed it, and if you have any questions, any queries related to this or any other, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more videos. Thank you.